Hey everybody, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner. Today we're going to be talking about how do you get started with pivot tables? What the heck are they? How do you use them? And how do you just even begin to get going with them? All right? Alliance is counting on you. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below, turn on that alarm bell so you don't miss any future mission. Okay, so when you're working in Power BI, right? You're in Power BI, you love it, you consume information in there, but you've got a grid of table, or there's a table, or there's some data in there. You want to extract it, you want to do something with it, because you want to mash it up and do some other things with it, right? And it's, you know, Power BI gives you some good information, but you want something else with it, right? You want to do some more with it, or you're told to, you know, take it out and pivot it, right? Like, what the heck are you going to do? Well, this is where we bring in our old friend Excel, right? Like, Excel is still a big guy that we're going to be using all the time, right? So we're going to take data from Power BI, and we're going to bring it out into Excel, all right? So let's hover my desktop so we can go over how the heck we even do it. Okay, so we are in Power BI, right? So here we are. We're in the Power BI service. We're going to go over to one of our big favorite reports, and this is our embedded paginated report. It gives us a lot of great details, information in here about our salespeople, the different markets that they work in, and it really gives us a ton of detailed information. In this case, we're going to really be honing in on our France sales force. You know, we've got some things going on in the EU. We want to go in and take a look at what's going on with these salespeople. So we want to go in, pull this information out. We're going to pull the information out. We're going to hit refresh on it. It's going to run this is going to be querying my data set. Pull all the details of all the order information out of it. I want to look at that information, and I want to do a pivot table on this. How the heck am I going to do this if I don't have access to the data set, but I have access to this paginated report, right? So I've got my report here. This paginated report and Power BI tables gives you a great opportunity to export information into Excel. So as you can see, I've got Excel highlighted here. I go ahead, download this from Excel. This is going to run for just a second. There we go. Up pops my file. I can open up where it is. It's in my downloads. When I open this up, it's going to be all the information that was inside of my report. So I can go over, I can click enable editing, and now I can start to do things with this report. Okay. So I'm going to, let me expand this all up. I want to do some first things. It's easy for me to look at and see what information is here. First, I want to do some quality checks, make sure that all my information is here. Now, as you remember, there were two salespeople over inside of my Power BI report, right? So it was, Barkley and Alberts, right? So I want to make sure I got Amy Alberts and Barkley here. So I've got Amy Alberts and Barkley. Yep. Okay. So that's good. I've got those two people here. Thumbs up. Good to go. Okay, so this is all the information I have, and this is really interesting, but this is so much, right? Like, so much information in here, thousands upon thousands of records. How am I going to, like, understand this? Well, here is where a pivot table comes into play. And a pivot table is something that is been around for a really long time, but just because it's been around for a long time doesn't mean everyone knows how to use it, right? And pivot table is really one of the foundational things that you need to, you know, begin to work with and operate with. All right. Now, the best way to do this is I've got my data, right? So I am going to hit control, and I'm going to hold down control and shift on my keyboard. I'm going to select the right, or I'm going to have first, I'm going to have selected the uppermost left cell that data is in, right? You see this guy right here? I'm going to hold down control shift. I'm going to press right arrow and right again until I get all of my columns. Then I'm going to press down until I hit the bottom. Now, what you're going to see is this is going to give me all of the columns that are inside of my table, and I'm going to get all of my rows, okay? The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Insert, and I'm going to go to Pivot Table, and I'm going to go from Pivot Table Range, okay? It's going to ask me, you know, is it this one big table range, and do I want to do it into an existing worksheet, or do I want to do a new worksheet? Just put it into a new worksheet. That'll be just fine. So go ahead, click OK. I need to unmerge and center it. Okay. Take that out. Now I've got, that's why I had that little break there, break in the join, Right, so sometimes you have to do some little like cleaning up on this. All right. So now I have all my information is in this reseller name column. And now I've got this little column here that I need to delete out. So I'm going to delete this out. All right. And I'm going to go back to where I have my employee name. And again, control shift, right arrow. Oh, there we go. We found another one that had the same issue. All right. We're going to eliminate that merge. We got that all of a sudden, but we're going to delete out the blank column, open this guy back up again. Now I've got, I should have everything that's available for me. Again, I should be able to select the upper leftmost or upper leftmost column, control shift right all the way over, down, all the way down. This is what is necessary to get this to work. I go to insert, I go to pivot table, I go from table range. And it's going to ask me, you know, is it from this selection? Yes. I want to go into a new worksheet. Yes. I'm going to click on OK. Now, this data could have come from anywhere. I just showed you Power BI as an example. This could have come from, an, you know, just a CSV file that you had in place. You know, this could have come from a dozen different places. OK. So one of the things I do like to do when I have a pivot table is I like to expand the number of columns that are available for my pivot table around this, and I'm going to show you why in just a second. But now what I can do with the pivot table is now I can start to do things like slice and dice the information that I'm looking at, right? So I've got all of my field names over here. This is accessible to me. So I can start to do things like, Okay. So I can go in and I can do things like, make sure that I understand the sales amount, this total sales amount. One good tip with pivot tables, make sure that you have something in the values space before you move on and do anything else. Okay, so I've got something in my value space, which is sales amount, and maybe I want to have order quantity. Okay, I got both of these things here. Notice that I've got my sales, sum of sales amount here and sum of order quantity here. And now I can go in and I could do things like take my employee name and stick it on my rows, right? So this is going to break all of my values up by the different salespeople that are in and work, you know, they're doing work. Now maybe I want to understand something along the lines of what about the region that they're working in? Oh, France, Germany, and United Kingdoms. Amy's selling to multiple regions, where Rajit is only selling to France, right? You know, that could be a big indicator of why we have, you know, differences in sales amounts here. But you know, if we go in and look, you know, sometimes it's hard to compare, right? Like I have some formatting challenges here. So I'm going to go in, I'm going to format this as currency. You know, I'm going to say English is fine. I don't want any zeros on this though. You know, so I can go in and easily see that, you know, Rajit has 4.5 million in sales. Amy only has 700,000 sales. Oh, maybe Amy's not having enough focus, right? Like I can now start to do all sorts of things when it comes to analyzing my information. I can add in something along the lines of like reseller name. How many different resellers are they working with? I can, you know, kind of juggle it up so I can see, you know, like, okay, here's the number Amy has. Here's the number that Rajit has. You know, I have all sorts of capabilities to drag, drop, slice and dice these things, right? Like I can look also by like order date, right? So let me put in an order date on this stuff. I can see how things are working and the, you know, when that information is coming in. Notice that it's auto selecting the dates for me, but this is still pretty wide, so maybe I don't want this to be quite as wide. I can now start to do things around like my pivot table design, right? So maybe I don't want to do not show subtotals, right? So I could start to collapse that information. And maybe I want to, you know, I'm going to collapse my 2019. You know what? I'm going to go, I'm going to select a value. I'm going to collapse all of my everything, right? And collapse the entire field. So I could see all of the values. I could see 2019. I could see 2020, 2021, right? And maybe I just want these as columns, right? And I don't want my values on the columns. I want my values on the rows. So I'm going to drag my little summation, my little values guy right here. I'm going to drag that down. And now I've got clean columns on here, right? What this allows me to do is do all sorts of drilling, slicing and dicing into the information that I have. You know, maybe this is really good for what I wanted to see. Maybe now I want to add in some sort of flavor, like, okay, you know, we did a region before, but now we want to do, where did my region go? Oh, sales territory region. I want to break that out by the year so I can see what they did in each of the different years and the regions that they were in and how they did their breakout, right? This allows me to go in and see the distribution of information and where those sales are going. I can get a, you know, I can break that out by adding that into sales territory here. I could drag that down here so I could see that across the years, whichever really makes it easier for me to do the work. Then I can also come in, I can select this pivot table, I can go to insert, I can go to recommended charts. It'll give me some recommended charts that might be useful for me when it comes to visualizing the information that I have. Now this is, you know, it's jumping to just a handful of these things. Maybe these are going to be useful, maybe they're not. I don't like any of these. These don't look good, so I'm not going to visualize any of that stuff because it's just a little too much. But as you can see, really easy once you've extracted the information to then go in, drag and drop information inside of here. Now you can go in and you can, you could do stuff like collapse the entire field. We already covered that, right? So I could collapse it all. I could see all the information on it. I can collapse this one. And collapse entire field, right? Like I now have a drill pattern on this. This makes this report really useful for people when it comes to going in, exploring the information, finding out more what's going on. Frankly, there is so much you could do with pivot tables, but this is a great starting point for you. I hope you found this useful. I thank you guys very much. You guys have a great day. Peace.